a powerful upscaling tool right on your phone that works completely offline. That means no internet needed, zero privacy worries, and lightning-fast performance thanks to hardware acceleration. Plus, it's totally free. I'm on an Android tablet right now, just to show you how this thing works. But honestly, it's gonna be just as smooth on your phone if you've got an Android or whatever. Anyway, we are talking about this app called SuperImage AI Enhancer. It's pretty nifty. You can use it to like sharpen up your photos, make them look way better, all that good stuff. And just so you guys can find it easily, I'm gonna drop a link to it down in the video description. So you can just click on that and grab it for yourself. You open up the app and this is what you see, the home screen. Pretty straightforward, and you'll see it's got these three main things you can do, nice and clear. First off, there is enhanced portraits. That's your go-to if you've got selfies or photos of people that you want to look a little more polished. Then there's photo upscaling. This is where you take these photos that are a bit blurry or low res and you make them bigger and sharper. And then last but not least, you've got anim upscaling. This is the cool one, especially if you're into illustrations or anim style art. Let's dive right in and we'll start with enhanced portraits. Now, the first thing you'll notice is that they give you a couple of choices for how you want your finished photo to look. Basically, what kind of file you want it to be. You've got JPEG and PNG, but they're telling us right there that JPEGs are generally better for real life photos. So that's what we're gonna choose here. Select add images to load photo for enhancement. I have this noisy photo of an old man. Okay, so I'm gonna tap on enhance. Now here's a heads up. The very first time you use this feature, it's gonna do a little download thing in the background. It's grabbing all the AI smarts it needs to make your portraits look amazing. Think of it like it's loading up its brain with all the portrait fixing knowledge. This is just a one-time process. You only have to do this once. After it's done, you are good to go, and you won't need the internet anymore to enhance your photos. You can use it anywhere, anytime. Just a quick thing to keep in mind though, because it's downloading those resources, you will want to make sure you have got enough space on your phone. These days, most phones have tons of storage, so it probably won't be a problem, but it's always good to double check. It's even telling you a couple of things, the resolution of the finished photo, so you know how big and detailed it's gonna be, and also an estimate of how long it's gonna take. Pretty handy. Now here's a little heads up. While it's doing its thing, your phone might slow down a bit. So if you're planning on doing a bunch of other stuff on your phone at the same time, you might notice things getting a little sluggish. Just something to keep in mind. Once it's all done, just tap on the thumbnail and you can see the before and after. They got this cool slider thing. You just drag it back and forth and you can see the before and after results like right next to each other. It's so easy to see the difference, and honestly the details are insane. You can really see it in the eyes. They just pop now. They're so much sharper. And you can see individual strands of hair. It's not just some blurry mess anymore. And of course the skin looks smoother, more even, like a really natural enhancement. But it's not just about smoothing things out. It's also about getting rid of that grainy noise you sometimes get in photos. The whole image just looks cleaner, clearer, and remember, it's 4 times the resolution of the original. That's a huge difference. And the best part, all of this happened offline. No internet needed. It's all done right there on your phone. The apps already saved the enhanced photo to your gallery. I've been playing around with this and I tried it on a bunch of old photos, the ones that are a little faded and blurry. And the results are amazing. I'll show you a few examples just to give you an idea of how well this thing works on different kinds of portraits. So now let's talk about upscaling regular photos, not just portraits. Now this is where things get really interesting, because they give you a bunch more options, including the ability to upscale your photos by a whopping 16 times their original size. Now here's the thing, while 16 times sounds super cool, it's gonna take a while. Your phone's gonna be working really hard and you probably won't want to be doing anything else on it for a good long while. Honestly, for most people, 4x upscaling is gonna be more than enough. You'll get a big sharp image without having to wait forever. But if you are rocking a lower end phone, you know, maybe an older model, here's a little tip. Even though you might be tempted to go with the faster option, always choose high quality. It's going to make a big difference in the final result. Yeah, it might take a little longer, but you'll get a much cleaner, sharper, and more detailed image. It's definitely worth the wait. So remember, high quality is your friend, especially if your phone's a little older. I grabbed this super old low resolution photo, the kind that's all grainy and noisy, and I decided to give the upscaling a whirl. And I'm seriously impressed with the details it managed to pull out. And then I tried another one, this old photo of a train. It's another one that was pretty rough to start with, and again the results were amazing. It brought out all these details not just on the train itself, but even in the leaves on the trees in the background. Now, I'll be honest, the faces in the train photo did come out a little wonky. They look a bit strange, but you have to remember the original photo had very limited information to work with. And now let's check out anime upscaling feature. This is where things get really fun, especially if you're into cartoons, illustrations, or anything anime style. Basically, it's designed to make those kinds of images super crisp and clear. So I grabbed this low resolution image of Bart Simpson. It's pretty blurry and pixelated, perfect for testing this out. Now, when you look at the options, it tells you right away that the output images are gonna be massive 16 times larger than the original. That's a huge jump in size. Alright, so I'm gonna tap on upscale, and just like with the portrait enhancement, it's gonna do a little one-time download thing. But don't worry, this one's even smaller, so it's gonna be super quick. There you go, the results are in. They're so clean and sharp. The illustration looks good. It's like it's been redrawn in high definition. This feature is really impressive if you have any digital art or cartoons you want to make look super sharp. It really does a fantastic job of cleaning up those lines and making everything pop. Alright, so let's just talk about this app for a second, because honestly, I'm pretty impressed. Even if you want to take it to the next level, they're not trying to lock you into some monthly fee. They have a pro version, yeah, but it's a one-time payment. You pay once and you get all the extra goodies. And what do you get with the pro version? You can load your own custom AI models, which is super cool if you're into that kind of thing. You can queue up a whole bunch of images to process at once, so you don't have to sit there tapping away. And of course, you get rid of the ads, which is always a plus. So I got this awesome free app that works offline. And if you want more, you can get a one-time upgrade. Honestly, in today's world of subscriptions, this app is definitely one you shouldn't just ignore. Other than few drawbacks, which I'm sure will be corrected in future, this is the app you must try. Hope you found the video useful, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.